Let's go to Joy. No, go to Joy in Raleigh, North Carolina. Good morning.
Hey, somebody from down south.
Well, you're right. I'm from down south.
Oh, God's mom.
And I'm your mother. And I disagree that all families are like ours.
The newest member to the Taylor County Sheriff's Department may not look like your average deputy.
Well, hey, Deputy Taylor, how are you doing today?
Sadly, the newest addition to the force won't be staying for long, but according to Griffin, he will be back for many more years to come.
Hey, that's the show, everybody. Before we go, obviously, as we always do, we check in with our good friend Stephen Colbert at the Colbert Report. Hey, Stephen, what's happening? I'm excited for the show tonight. How you feeling?
I'm always excited, John.
Right, but I mean, tonight's a very special show, very, very, very exciting show.
I like to think every show is special, John. It's a little something called professionalism.
Well, obviously, you're not ready to share any feelings yet, I understand.
What feelings, John? I'm an emotionless, igneous news rock.
All right, well, I just want to say have a great show, and are you ready?
I'm more than ready, John. In fact, Jimmy, grab it!
And that's our show, everybody. You know, people always ask me, you know, what do you watch on television? Well, one of the things I watch the most is ESPN, and one of the greatest people that I ever saw on ESPN was Stuart Scott. So here it is, your moment is in.
If you're Warren Moon, what are you doing at this hour? Watching Sports Night? We know.
Call Konerkel Butter, because he is on a roll.
The big 7'1", 330-pound brother who strides up court like this after bringing down the house.
Top five. Yeah. Swoops with the steal. Swoops, there it is. On the ballot where the party at. Swoops, there it is.
And here it is. Your moment is in.
Hi, Caroline O'Neill. I'm Gene Finnegan's son.
Good to see you. How are you?
I knew this would happen.
I'll tell you what, man. I may be Irish, but I'm not stupid.
No, you're not stupid.
Better days. Here it is. Your moment is end.
Last thing. David Cameron said over the weekend that the president calls him bro. Is that true? And is there any other pet names he has for world leaders?
Well, to paraphrase a local baseball player here in Washington, D.C., that's a clown question, bro.
Who would have thought that legendary TV comedian Bob Newhart would have been trending on Twitter during the national championship game between Oregon and the Ohio State? Well, here's why. Notice a bit of a resemblance between referee Greg Burks and the TV legend.
Here it is now. Your moment is in.
Did your bartender of 5 years try to poison you? Did your daughter get charged with beating you to death with a fruit bowl and stuffing your corpse in a suitcase? Maybe your BFF, the brand new one, is Kim Jong-un. If your answer to all those three is no, then you're better off than the people in the news this hour.
Experience. Almost kind of looks like what the Earth looks like when you're a bazillion miles away from the planet
moon.
Yes,
yes, I just squinted at it.
From the moon, looking back at the Earth.
From the planet moon. From the planet
moon. Isn't the moon a star?
The moon is such a planet. I can't even stand it.
The moon is not a planet.
What else is it if it's not a planet?
It is not.
Here it is. Your moment is in.
I am officially announcing that the Tea Party is taking Dr. Martin Luther King away from the liberal left. From this day forward, Dr. Martin Luther King is officially a Tea Party hero.
Members of Hillary Clinton's inner circle say they're delighted. One even told the New York Daily News, "I would like to run against Mitt Romney in every election, forever."
Hey, Mr. Vice President. How do you feel about addressing Republicans, the president doing so?
Well, I think it's great.
And you have members of the House.
Think I don't get begging, you must be mistaken. See the full I Get Begging video at YouTube.com.
Who was the one. Now, with tea time on the mind, he is so over it. America, he's just not that into you.
He's
got 16 miles an hour gusts here in Stony Brook. Now, this is just down the street from Port Jefferson, and I'm going to throw my anemometer off to the side. And if you... Everybody's having a great time out here, obviously, with the snow. President Obama is once again getting flack on the international stage for chewing gum. Cameras captured him apparently chewing gum on multiple occasions. He even took it out of his mouth once while chatting with the prime minister and then put it back in.
Here it is. Your moment is in.
You're going to have to shut up or I'm going to have you arrested. If we can't get the Capitol Hill police in here immediately. Get out of here, you low-life scum.
I'm hoping the others drop out, leave me by myself. That would be delightful for me. And if that news happens the rest of the next few months, I would be delighted, Dana. That would be great.
Don't hold your breath.
And don't forget, we got ourselves a podcast now. Without me, you can download it there. And it's got an interview with our own Trevor Noah. And so you should check out that. But here it is. Your moment is in.
All right, everybody, here comes Jimmy the Groundhog.
It was a frigid day as all of these eyes and ears waited to experience Jimmy's prognostication firsthand.
Welcome to Jimmy the Groundhog.
Jimmy made a grand entrance.
You've said things about my Texas that just were not kind. And if I get a chance, I'll open up a cowboy boot shop and you're behind.
This is his interview, and here it is, your moment of zen. Minimum wage, you want to take affirmative or negative?
Of raising the minimum wage?
Yeah.
I'll take negative.
Boom, done. You start.
Well, you're the affirmative. You're supposed to start.
All right, but you start anyway because it's my show.
State and local authorities are trying new methods to urge parents to vaccinate their kids. KTLA's Steve Kuz live in Hollywood. Steve.
I'll put you to the hospital next year.
Years ago, Micah and Cher, the measles was virtually eradicated in the United States.
I am a terrible employee. But in my heart, I know it is time for someone else to have that opportunity. And that I told you they didn't know. You probably know. Not right away. It's going to be, we're still working out details. I'm up in September. Might be around then. It's been an absolute privilege. It's been the honor of my professional life. And I thank you for watching it, for hate watching it. Whatever reason you were tuning in for, you get in this business with the idea that maybe you have a point of view and something to express, and to receive feedback from that is the greatest feeling you can ask for. And I thank you. And here it is. Your moment is in.
If vans and butts were candy and nuts, every day would be Christmas.
It's going to be a clean DHS funding bill. Are you going to put it on the floor? Are you going to kill it? Are you going to let them vote on it? Have you even had this discussion?
If ifs and buts were terrible answers to questions, what are you doing? The only question would have been an appropriate response to is, Speaker Boehner, would you mind letting the entire press corps know how you call your cat? Here it is, your moment is done.
A solar eclipse. The cosmic ballet goes on.
Does anyone want to switch seats?
So, for instance, if you say, hello, Renee, try that.
Hello, Renee.
So I would teach you how to enhance that, how to increase the range. Hello, Renee.
Hello, Renee.
What Hillary did was completely compliant. It's exactly what everybody else has done who's had that job. And Republicans are now hyperventilating 1 hour and then wetting the bed the next. So get them a brown paper bag or Depends or something.
Wow.
President Putin vowed to personally oversee the investigation.
Oh, good. He's vowing to find the real killer. That's a promise that always inspires confidence.
Utah is considering a bill that would allow some patients to be treated with edible forms of marijuana. An agent for the DEA says if that bill passes, the state's wildlife may suffer. He says they may cultivate a taste for the plant, lose their fear of humans, and basically be high all the time.
Former President Truman was quoted by the AP as saying that the march from Selma, and this was his word, was silly.
I think it was the most powerful and dramatic civil rights protest that has ever taken place in the South.
True happiness is the happiness that comes from being honored. I love scrolls, I love plaques, I love trophies. I got a building named after me. Someone actually once said, a good deed is its own reward. Well, then what's this?
Another video has surfaced. This one appears to show the fraternity's 78-year-old house mother using that same racial slur back in 2013.
The former house mom, her name, Botan Gilbo.
This is terrible, but I will say, it is a bit of a relief when you're doing a horrible story and everything seems so dark. But for comic relief, in walks Futon Elbow.
Botan Gilbo.
Bon Bon Pillow.
Botan Gilbo.
Tauntaun Armadillo.
Botan Gilbo.
Beyonce Sarsaparilla.
Botan Gilbo.
Boca Raton Dildo. I'm sorry.
Do you trust Hillary Clinton did nothing wrong? Text A for yes, text B for no to 67622. We'll bring you the results later on in the show.
Well, the big meltdown is revealing some very unwanted surprises across the city. Piles and piles of dog poop. There have been many more feces complaints made to the city's 311 websites. If you're a dog owner, do the right thing, scoop the poop. It does not melt away with the snow.
The whole world's on fire.
The world is on fire. Yes, your world is on fire.
Thank you for your distinguished career in the Secret Service and for stepping up and taking over this agency at such a difficult time. When I was a young boy, I always looked up. I mean, the Secret Service, wow, that was it.
Here is Jack. Go ahead.
Hi, good morning. I'm calling from Bel Air, California, but I am originally from West Philadelphia. A couple of guys who were up to no good essentially started causing trouble in my neighborhood.
Again, for the first 45 minutes, around negotiations.
They were warned, Ed. Multiple letters. It does remind me a little bit of Benghazi with the request for more security. It's not that this was a surprise. It's government-run health care.
The head of the San Francisco's Department of Public Works is looking into a paint that repels liquids. The paint would redirect urine back onto the person. It's already being used in Hamburg, Germany, where signs say, do not pee here, we pee back.
There is hidden racism rampant. In the House and the Senate. If it looked like a duck, walked like a duck, and quacked like a duck, it's a duck.
Daniel Podolsky spent the afternoon in Lambert Airport looking for a ride. He was kicked off his flight because of the T-shirt under his jacket. This is the shirt, advertising a Comedy Central show called Broad City. The shirt says Broad Effing City.
You guys all care about politics?
Yes,
of course I care about politics because our future depends on us. Our country's future depends on us, so we care a lot about politics.
You care that much, you didn't even notice that motorcycle.
Yeah.
Wow.
Gays have all the rights that they want. All they gotta do is marry a person of the opposite sex.
Oh, okay. So as long as gays don't be gay, they've got all the rights they want.
You shouldn't have special rights just because of the type of sex you have. What? Where's that in the Constitution?
It ain't.
That's right.
Yeah!
Jason Jones, who has always been at this program, the most interesting man in the world.
It's my way or the die way.
I'm a parent just like you. And when I'm not reporting on world events, I'm hanging out with my daughter.
I'm the world's greatest rapper in English in Farsi. I got more rhymes than Tabbouleh got parsley.
I love you very much, Nana. I love you, Nana.
I love you.
We need a super PAC. Right here in Coralville.
What's it look like I'm doing, John?
I'll tell you what it looks like you're doing, but then...
John, relax. I'm playing Wii Craps.
Oh, God, thank you.
While I masturbate.
No, oh, next!
Let's just go coffee.
Some people stand in the darkness, afraid to step into the light. Some people need to help somebody when the air just
Get on the ground.
What? Put it down.
Is it on the ground now?
It's a t-shirt cannon.
I like you a lot.
All right, thanks, man.
Give me a kiss.
On the cheek.
Yeah? How'd that feel?
It was nice. Admit it, it was nice.
Can you do that on cable TV?
Of course I can. I can do a lot more than that. I'm always ready.
Boom!
Boom! Obamacare is going to be one of the worst things. One of the worst things in American history.
Do you remember slavery?
Can you see it? Oh, no, it's a bee. That's okay, guys. Hold on. You guys are wild things. You're not supposed to be scared of bees.
A top cleric lauded the agreement.
I should really congratulate all the gentlemen who led the nuclear talks. Great job.
I have to say that sometimes when I listen to less than loving expressions by Christians, I get concerned. But that's a topic for another day.
Connie Cooperman, keep kicking that ass. Here it is. Your moment is at.
Remember to eat a green thing every day and have lots of calcium. It's very important for young mothers to have lots of calcium. There you are. See you tomorrow night.
Bye.
How are you this evening?
And then apparently Madonna sucker kissed Drake, and I assume to lay one of her that looked like she laid one of her eggs in his stomach.
And the Americans are already in the finals.
We're in the finals?
Yes!
USA! Wait. Wow.
They're so...
Really?
Like warmongers?
Talking about getting us in a war. Is it really that easy? Yeah. All right. You know what? Let me ask you a question.
Politics and stuff and jokes. I'm back.
Politics and stuff and jokes.
The funny ones.
It's just hard. You've summed me up.
And now you're gone, and that's it.
Let me ask you a question.
Tell me.
Did you really see my movie?
No. I don't like your movies.
Son of a bitch.
Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, I'm in you.
Yes, I know.
I'm being you. I'm you, you're me.
I don't want to.
Let's switch it around. You know what's sad?
The good news for Newt Gingrich is that his gradual rise in the polls has turned into a surge. He, you know, wasn't a perfect husband, did things that were wrong. He's asked God's forgiveness. I think a lot of Republican voters will accept that.
Here it is. Your moment is in.
Okay, they're going around to the back, so we're not going to... You can see the media running behind me here to chase the Scooby van.
Wow.
And she's going around to the back.
Wow, they're...
All right, and we'll see her very soon.
Guy in the orange pants is pretty quick.
Decorum is very important to the state Senate in Minnesota, so they're keeping some rules so things don't get crazy. Senators voted to keep the rule that says they cannot make eye contact during a floor debate. This is not video of a floor debate. This is from Curb Your Enthusiasm. Sure.
So we're going to be very aggressive on that issue as well as on the geographic preference issue.
Ah, come on. Just let it go, Mr. Sorry about that.
The next 20 months are going to be a Hobbesian state of nature. It's going to be like Lord of the Flies. But let me tell you something. January 2017 is coming.
Your moment is ending.
Pray with me. Pray these words. Jesus, that's right. Pray with me, Jesus. You know everything I've done. You know the filthy things. You know how I've misused my body.
What categories will you investigate? Paper, cardboard, plastic bottles, aluminum cans? It's up to you to figure all that out. So good luck and make me happy. The more you fill me up, the happier I am.
That is our show. Here it is. Your moment is in.
We'll catch up. People will be informed. They'll find out all about the scholarship winners. They'll find out all of what happened in the streets of Baltimore by this time tomorrow.
And he has agreed, and I have requested, and he has agreed to deploy the National Guard.
When the mayor called me, which, quite frankly, we were glad that she finally did, is instantly we signed the executive order.
Ooh. Well, isn't the governor a little passive-aggressive? I mean, I was there all weekend, by the phone, but fine if she wants a city to burn. Who am I? I'm just a simple governor with the executive authority to provide a standing army of reservists. But I guess calling them out would not be on fleek, as the young people... You motherfuckers, you swore that that's a thing. You swore that on fleek was a thing. They swore to me. I said, on fleek? And they said, no, that's a thing. And I was like, I am going to punt you motherfuckers. I know that's a thing. I know that's a thing.
A police vehicle now getting through this area. And this shot from the helicopter, this follow, that cop car is going very fast right now, and presumably, I don't know where it's going.
That's our show. Here it is. Your moment is in.
Police complaints about noisy sex. Is there any other kind, though?
But what may be the most infamous apartment building in New York? Sex is not a quiet thing.
Oh, TJ Holmes, I'm going to tell you about something else. Okay. I'm not going to go there.
I'm allergic to wheat. Sugar, bumblebees, milk, wool, cotton, poly blends, pony hair, oatmeal. So I should probably also mention that I'm a virgin and a bedwetter.
Beards are big in size and popularity, and now we're finding out some are also as dirty as a toilet.
Thanks for sharing. Mm.
A lot of people were surprised that your team did not register CarlyFiorina.org, but someone else did, and they said, Carly Fiorina failed to register this domain, so I'm using it to tell you how many people she laid off at Hewlett-Packard. It was this many. That's 30,000 people she laid off. They used frowny faces.
Got to be Jersey. It's got to be. Damn it! I thought I would get that one. All right, I get it. You doubled up on
what
that.
A loser!
That actually seemed a bit over the line. So it's.
No, you got a tiny penis.
Seemed like an awfully personal insult. So.
Especially the one who's actually from Canada.
Look yeah. That's right. But now I'm confused. So if Marco Rubio and Ted Cruz are not the Latinos in the race, who is the Latino in the Republican race?
John, listen, and I will tell you a tale of the legend of a candidate for president who speaks fluent Spanish and has a Mexican wife who raised Mexican children and regularly eats Mexican food And this man is a Republican.
But that's, no, it's not possible.
John, the legend is real. And his name is Yeb.
Yeb?
Yes.
Yeb?
Yeb.
Yeb?
Or as we call him, El Yebe.
After church to go prepare for Sunday fun day in my house. We'll be cooking Iowa beef, and I'll probably make a really good guacamole.
Ah. You hear how that guacamole rolls off the tongue?
That's our show. Here it is. The moment is at.
Mi esposa Columba nació en México. Mi familia tiene fuertes lazos con México. Y yo tengo un gran respeto y cariño por nuestros vecinos. Feliz Cinco de Mayo para todos.
The harvest left no food for you to eat. You cannibal, you meat eater, you see. I have seen the same, I know the shame in your defeat.
So racism has its own inertia, and for us to change it, we have to do something active to counteract that inertia. Right. Yeah. No, I agree. There's been a great conversation. I almost feel like the type of conversation somebody would write a song about.
Yeah. Who knows?
If there is somebody that... Can I tell you something? I say this with all due respect, because you know I love you and I love the music.
Yes.
You writing that song for your wife really f***ed everybody.
Because... It made my life better.
There's not a card, there's not a gift that I can give.
Just push play,
that,
man.
That someone would just say, like...
Just push play.
Mr. Miliband, how is the country doing for you tonight?
Well, you know, what I say is, you know, it looks as though we may not get all that we want.
And Mr. Cameron, how is the result looking for you?
Well, Richard, I think that's a very good question, and I'm very glad you asked it. It's very, very splendid.
That's our show. Here it is. The moment is at.
I have actually answered over 200 on the record questions since Monday. I have to admit that one of those questions was, did I consider a hot dog a sandwich? So, we'll subtract that one. What do you all think? Is a hot dog a sandwich?
The effort to suggest that the poor are sponges, leeches, are don't want to work, are lazy. If you watch Fox News on a regular basis, it is a constant menu. They will find, like, folks who make me mad. I don't know where they find them, right? They're all like, I don't want to work. I just want a free Obama phone or whatever. And that becomes an entire narrative.
Really?
In my opinion, the president is spinning his own policy failures. As the middle class shrinks, and the poor are trapped in this system, so to speak, the president blames us, the honest messengers.
The handout nation rolls on. We hand out $79 billion every January to these so-called poor people.
You're not being mean to poor people today.
I am. I am being mean to poor people. Well, frankly, I am. Many poor families have homes with cable TV, cell phones, computers, you name it, much, much more. 99% of them have a refrigerator. 81% have a microwave. You're going to give us the emotional side of the story? People need $15 per hour to live on. They're starving without it. Okay, I got that. The image we have of poor people as starving and living in squalor really is not accurate. Many of them have things. What they lack is the richness of spirit. We've looked at the food stamp program, not at the recipients. We haven't characterized the recipients. We've looked at the program. We're not saying that the recipients of food stamps are bad people or that they're lazy.
Really?
Our first course of this meal, an amuse douche, if you will.
America's poor are actually living the good life.
Just call them pennies from government heaven.
The United States of entitlement.
A nation of takers.
Entitlement society.
Scary. There's this misconception that people derive their values from their scriptures. And the truth is that it's more often the case that people insert their values into their scriptures. I mean, otherwise, every Christian who read the Bible would read it exactly the same way. In this country, not 200 years ago, both slave owners and abolitionists not only used the same Bible to justify their viewpoints, mm-hmm. they used the same verses to do so. I mean, that's a thing about Scripture. Its power comes from its malleability. You can read it in any way you want to. If you are a violent misogynist, you will find plenty in the Quran or in the Bible to justify your viewpoint. If you're a peaceful feminist, you will find just as much in those scriptures to justify your viewpoint.
What if you're a Jew who loves a bacon egg sandwich?
An unexpected and unwelcome visitor dropped into a children's clothing store in a Hong Kong shopping mall over the weekend. Network iCable reports that the wild boar chewed clothing on a mannequin.
Can't read my poker face.
I hate that song.
Here it is. Your moment is in.
I'm aware I may not be the youngest candidate in this race, but I have one big advantage. I've been coloring my hair for years.
Really?
That's our show. Join us next week at 11. Here it is. Your moment is in.
I'm not going to tell you what it is tonight. You know, one of the problems that we have, I'll tell you why, because I don't want to, Greta. I'll tell you why, because I...
Why don't you tell? We need all the help we can get. We need a dialogue on this.
If I run, and if I win, I don't want the enemy to know what I'm doing.
Sections of the Patriot Act expired overnight after the Senate failed to act before a midnight deadline,
forcing the NSA to immediately stop collecting telephone metadata on millions of Americans across the country.
As JFK said, some men see things as they are and ask why. I see things that never were and ask why not.
Pulling all U.S. troops out of Iraq directly led to groups like ISIS quickly achieving power in our country.
The fact that they didn't leave a residual force in Iraq is the reason why we're facing ISIS today.
ISIS is the creation that happened after we pulled all of our troops out in 2011. That is the key mistake. It was made by this administration.
Obama's decision to pull troops out of Iraq was only following the dictates of the 2008 Status of Forces Agreement that President Bush signed with Iraq, or as historians now refer to that agreement, the status of DUCK! Oh, by the way, another Bush presidency Iraq mistake. You don't go to the Status of Forces Agreement press conference without wearing shoe helmet one. No.
Bruce Jenner is now Caitlyn Jenner. I want you to check out the new Vanity Fair cover to Dagan McDowell on what the hell is going on.
San Andreas making a seismic debut, rocking the box office, over 50 million opening this weekend.
Unbelievable opening. And let's take a look at Nick Watt right now. He's actually in an earthquake simulator. As you can see, it is live.
Ladies and gentlemen, our first look back.
Thurman added. Your moment is in.
I'm seriously considering the possibility of running for president. That's the language that I'm using just for a little bit longer until I make up my mind.
Earlier, the officer could be seen chasing boys and cursing as he forced them to the ground.
Don't make me
around here with 30 pounds of goddamn gear on the sun because you want to screw around out here?
By the way, I've never seen a cop run through a frame and do a little parkour somersault in the manner that he did.
That takes me back to another modern-day poet by the name of Jay-Z. In one of his songs he wrote, "It's funny what 7 days can change. It was all good just a week ago." Well, I don't know if it was all good a week ago, but I can tell you that things have really changed.
All I can think about is the hills are alive with the sound of music.
Oh, sick!
Self. New Pandora channel, news anchors singing show tunes. Just gonna get through that. Let me go. When you're a jet for. All right, that's a good one. Wait, give me another one. Give me another one. Papa, can you hear me? The sun will come.
The president literally turned his back on the prime minister.
Was it a snub? An oversight? What?
An awkward moment.
This was clearly a snub.
The snub heard round the world.
It was awkward, but was it a snub?
I think it's more hashtag awkward. Brooke, I think it's more like on the awk scale. Between like totes, not awk, and OMFG awkpocalypse. I would say it rates a solid awk-a-doodle-doo.
Just as a matter of full disclosure, I am the smarter, nicer, funnier version of your co-host.
Don't let him say anything mean about me when I get off the air.
That I can't help. That is generally the pattern I've noticed between you two.
I've done a 45-year sentence as his brother so far, and I've made it.
Yeah.
The problem is they haven't built a prison that can hold me yet, other than marriage.
Ha-ha! Gotcha, bro! By the way, I'm going to need to stay at your place tonight.
All public officials should be like this, because some of the public officials, they're like not even my height. But you're a big man, and I think that always helps. New York City should have a big mayor.
Thank
New York
you,
State, maybe you could, you know, they should have a bigger person maybe in public office. But I mean, that's we take what we can get.
People call water a right. Some people call water, you know, the essence of life. Waters of baptism, the waters of poetry.
Where are you going, Al?
I'm going to paint this town wet, John.
Oh, for God's sake, Al. Your moment is in.
You got to say this is a tough day for Rick Santorum. He's campaigning in Hamlin, Iowa. Population 301 person shows up at the event for Rick Santorum. Then he moves on to Denison, and I guess we could say he's doubling his crowds as he goes. Two people showed up for Rick Santorum.
Miss Piggy received the Sackler Center First Award last night from the Brooklyn Museum. It honors women for feminism art. Some say Miss Piggy shouldn't have gotten the award because, you know, she's a Muppet.
Are you African American?
I don't understand the question.
In the 90s, I thought, lots of fun tweets. So we'll start with Dee, who says, in the 90s, I thought that computers
were much easier to use. Remember the green flashing, you know, in the dial-up?
Oh, yeah, sure do. And I thought nothing will ever be as cool as crystal meth.
Pepsi.
What an entrance! An escalator down. Now, I haven't seen an entrance that majestic since my friend met me at the Gap after grabbing an Orange Julius.
I am officially running for President of the United States, and we are going to make our country great again.
And what followed was over half an hour of the most beautifully ridiculous jibber-jabber ever to pour forth from the mouth of a back billionaire.
The U.S. has become a dumping ground for everybody else's problems. They're laughing at us. How stupid are our leaders? We have losers. We have losers. When did we beat Japan at anything? China has our jobs, and Mexico has our jobs. When Mexico sends its people, they're bringing drugs, they're bringing crime, they're rapists, and some, I assume, are good people.
America's id is running for president. Trump is the part of your brain that's like at 3 a.m. going, let's go take a shit in the mailbox. Come on, who's gonna know?
I'm really rich. I'll show you that in a second. I've done an amazing job. A total net worth of $8 billion. Net worth, not assets. I have the best courses in the world. The Grand Hyatt Hotel, the Convention Center on the West Side, Trump Tower, Bank of America building in San Francisco. I just sold an apartment for $15 million to somebody from China.
This speech was so f***ed up that in the middle of it, all the liquid in his body tried to escape through the corner of his mouth. Thank you, Donald. Thank you, Donald Trump, for making my last 6 weeks. What kind of idiot would willingly put this into their mouths?
You know what it's like? It's like pigs in a blanket.
The question is, do you actually start with the crust? That is the
big... Why wouldn't you?
Hawking fast food on the news? Is there any way this could get more inappropriate?
28 mini hot dogs baked in each crust.
Take it easy with finger banging the pizza there, brother. This is a morning show. Kids are watching. You save that for Fox and Friends after dark. This may be the greatest day of my life. Pizza Hut! Pizza Hut! Pizza Hut, how dare you? This is without a doubt the most repulsive, disgusting, nauseating fast food that I have ever seen in my life. And I gotta tell you something, when you take... Why do you have to... Oh, hey. Hey, Arby's, I was just talking to Pizza Hut. How long have you been there? No, Arby's, no, wait! Oh!
Sadly, the American dream is dead.
The crazy things I'm seeing put out in the media by big labor, the willingness to make up stories, to make up facts. Goebbels would be very proud of them.
Take Nancy Reagan seriously. When it comes to all three votes today, just vote no.
Well, I definitely am not white. I don't know necessarily if my skin color has changed. It depends on the season. I was drawing self-portraits with the brown crayon instead of the peach crayon.
Ayúdenos en tener una campaña que les da la bienvenida. Trabajen con nosotros por los valores que compartimos. Y para un gran futuro que es nuestro para construir.
I'm sorry, in Spanish he's hot.
Could we not argue that America is about freedom, whether we live it out or not? But it really is about freedom, equality, and the pursuit of happiness. And that's what church is all about. Freedom to worship and freedom from sin, freedom to be full what God intends us to be. and have equality in the sight of God.
Are you kidding me? Really?
Whoa, man, calm down. Hey, assistant here, 52nd 11. Ma'am, stop moving your arms.
Officer, if I may, I'm white. She's upset because she dropped her ice cream on the ground.
Oh, that stinks. Sorry. Call that one off.
Thanks, helper Whitey.
Plus, Pete and Clayton are facing off. They're testing their skills with the axe. Who's going to win this battle with the lumberjacks? That's coming up next.
You're running on Reagan's 1980 slogan, let's make America great again.
No, that's not it. My slogan is different. My slogan is make America great again. He said he put the word let's, but he didn't use the word again.
Forgetting the fact that Reagan did use the word again, it's right on the button. So you're using the word again. The only change you made to his slogan was the let's. So it's exactly the same slogan as Reagan, except ruder. Reagan's was an invitation. Yours is a command. Make America great again. Don't bother me until you do. I'll be inside a gold cylinder.
He doesn't want to accept that there is a channel that will criticize him. I realize that many people feel it's too much. It's too much criticism. But really, has Fox News been proven wrong on every single subject? That's what the left wants you to believe, that Fox News just invents, you know, stories, and that's what we exist to do.
It's only a matter of time before the cultural revolutionaries destroy films like Gone with the Wind and Forrest Gump and burn copies of Tom Sawyer and Huckleberry Finn. Oh, Stalin and Lenin would be bursting with pride. You know who else has been doing some cultural cleansing these days? These guys. The Islamic State.
These are all sort of routines that the Jindals have as a regular basis. The kids and the family live there at the mansion. He gets up every single morning and goes to the gym before he does anything, in large measure because there's this bacon drawer in the kitchen where there's always a couple of pounds of unbelievably good bacon sitting around.
Sauce. Oh, jiggery pokery.
You know how the scale, those old-fashioned ones have a 100-pound big chunk?
Yeah.
And then you chunk it over to 150?
110.
I'm always around 100, then you move up to 140, 145.
And good morning. We have an NBC News special report. We have breaking news coming from the U.S. Supreme Court.
Gillibrand will be joining us on the program, so you can tune into that. But right now, here it is, your moment of zen.
When I hear the media say that our country is angry, I know they're wrong. Last year, I went to 37 different states across this country in 1 year. I met people in every corner of America, and they are not angry. Americans are not angry. Americans are filled with anxiety.
17! Only two more and we unlock Sub-Zero. Ice Ninja. Obviously, he's going to have to moderate his spine ripping.
Hi, I'm Ted. With Harry Shearer retiring, I'm auditioning for any part I can get in The Simpsons. Smithers, release the hounds.
Heidly ho, neighbor. But Dad, I'm a vegetarian.
But Lisa, animals are so delicious.
Forward, not backwards. Upwards, not downwards. And always twirling, twirling for freedom. No, I won't listen.
Oh, my freaking ears.
But they're right. They're right.
I so love this man.
I really feel like he's some sort of Jewish holiday waiting to happen. Like, we thought the craziness would only last a day. But by a miracle, it burned for 8, 10, holy shit. That's what we should call it. Holy f***a. And you should have known that. You've been down this road before.
Well, first off, Nancy Pelosi is a dingbat.
Waterboarding is how we baptize terrorists.
Once you cast a spell and bring an internet comment to life, it no longer belongs to you. Only this time, the chat room troll emoji you've conjured has $10 billion of its own money. You thought Wasilla word salad was hard to shake? Wait till you get Trump dump on you.
I would make one change to that. You're assuming I'm already on the train. If you're the caboose, I'm that guy on that little cart that chasing you with the little handheld thing you see in cartoons.
I love it. You're a fine man. I've always enjoyed our conversations. I hope to have many more, and not just when we pass each other on the street, for God's sakes.
I love you, Jon Stewart.
I just to clarify, that was in the prompter. That was not, it was a beautiful reading.
Thank you.
But that was in the prompter.
Thank you.
John McCain goes, oh boy, Trump makes my life difficult. He had 15,000 crazies show up, crazies. He called them all crazy. I said, they weren't crazy. They were great Americans. These people, if you would have seen these people, I know what crazy is. I know all about crazies.
So I filmed a video, actually, of my friends telling them that Jennifer Lawrence was going to be, they're all like nurses and teachers, and I'm like, Jennifer Lawrence is coming on a boat with us tomorrow. So they're all screaming. And then we wound up going jet skiing, and I was like, I'll drive, I've got this. And then she was like, no,
wait,
I'm Hunger Games.
You guys went double debt, like back to back, she's on, you're on?
Yeah. Do you want me to talk slower?
Oh, no, no. I love this. I'm sorry. Let me take, no, that's it.
Wait, but in all these pictures.
But you know what that is?
What?
That's the next movie poster.
That's it.
That's young Amy Schumer. Thank you.
Trump obviously is financing his own campaign, doesn't have to go asking for money. And I'll leave you with this, Julie. Throughout the course of the day, we've had dozens of people come up and ask what we're doing and who we're here for, all of whom asked if Trump was here, and pretty much all of whom seemed disappointed when we told them no.
Of course, in Texas, we cook bacon a little differently than most folks.
Down. And I think that Starbucks has recognized that the flavor of their lattes, that they are using semen to make that latte even more flavorful.
You think they're using semen to flavor their lattes?
I think so, yes.
What empirical evidence do you have that Starbucks is using semen in their lattes?
What empirical evidence do I have?
Yeah.
I think if you're asking for that, you may not be able to find my explanation suitable to meet the empirical standards, but let's just say I know.
Your moment is in.
Donald's got lots of skills and lots of talents that have made him wealthy and made lots of people around him wealthy. That's a great thing. Mm-hmm. It's not necessarily the same skills that are transferable to governing. And so you need to understand how you have to work with other people.
What we've built here is a monument to evisceration. Issues, pundits, politicians. We here at the show left no target undisemboweled. In fact, if you're still walking around with a belly full of viscera, know this, we didn't forget you.
We'll put it all up on the web. And by the way, it wasn't just eviscerating. We demolished, crushed. We annihilated things. I can remember one night, even the Hulk was like, dude, hey, slow down. I mean, Hulk angry, but please. And so now, at the end of my tenure, with all my targets pulverized into ash before me, I'd like to take a moment to see my crushed enemies driven before me and hear the lamentation of their women. In our new segment, The Daily Show, Destroyer of Worlds. First up.
Well, you know, I'm going to miss watching you on this show. I think the most reliable way to take a good thing and make it go bad is to hold on to it too long. That's really the thing.
I think that's right.
So you got to let it go. And also, no, it's really time to go.
Tomorrow night is the final episode. It's gonna go long. So remember to set your thing and bring a snack, because we're gonna be here a while. Here it is, your moment of zen.
In a final tweet, Hitchbot said, "My love for humans will never fade." A thumbs up for people from the hitchhiking robot. Rage against the machine.